Everyone. So now in this topic we are going to cover the image formed by concave mirrors. So basically we have to study about what are concave mirrors. So concave mirrors are a type of a spherical mirror in which the reflecting surface is the inner side of that particular spherical mirror and it is painted silvery from the outer side so that no lights can pass through it. They are also called converging mirror due to their geometrical shape. Right. Now there are some important terms such as pole. So what is exactly is pole? That pole is the centermost point of the spherical mirror, the center of curvature. It is the center of a sphere of which once the mirror was part of. It means the sphere from which the mirror is cut, the center of curvature is the center of that sphere. Radius of curvature is the radial distance between center of curvature and the pole. And the principal axis is the straight line which connects center of curvature to the pole. And the focus is a special point of on which all the rays which are parallel to principal axis gets reflected through. Okay, so now the image formation here also the same law applies, that the law of reflections, that angle I is equals to angle R. We will discuss about it. So now there are some assumptions such as the incident ray which is falling on a spherical mirror, it is considered as so small space that it acts like a plane mirror. And the rays are coming from a nearer object, because if they are coming from the farther objects, the rays will be in random in nature and no clear picture will be formed, right? So these are an assumption. Now the image formation, first of all we have to take certain rays, such as we are taking a ray which is parallel to principal axis. So now if a ray is parallel to principal axis, so let us suppose that this is a spherical surface and this is the tangent of this a spherical object. So now we know that the tangent is completely 90 degree from the center. Any ray which is falling will be making a 90 degree from the center. So now in this case, if this is angle I, so this will be angle R. So we have seen that this ray is reflected to a specific point that is called focus. Not only this ray, only any ray which is parallel to principal axis will pass through focus. Any ray, right? So the next is that if a ray which is passing through center of curvature will retrace its path back, because in this case, see, the tangent lies here and it itself is on 90 degree. So angle of incidence here is 0 degree. So it will retrace its path. It means that it will reflect it through 0 degree only, right? Okay. Now, if any ray is falling directly to the pole of the mirror, it will have an oblique reflected point, that it will pass through pole and it will get reflected with the angle of R, which is same as angle of incidence. So in this case, this will be as angle I is equals to angle R, because in this case, center of curvature is acting as a normal of this point, right? Now objects at infinity. What if the objects are at infinity? So let us suppose that this is our object and here the ray diagrams are. So the rays are parallel to the principal axis here. This is the head part, this is the tail part. So we know that this particular point is going to be focus. And let us suppose that here somewhere is our center of curvature. So all the rays which are falling to this spherical mirror, let us assume that they are parallel to the principal axis. So they will form an image on the focal point, right? So this is how. Now what if objects are kept beyond our center of curvature? So see, if any object is kept beyond our center of curvature, so what will happen, that one line will be parallel to our principal axis, it will pass through our focus, and the second line which we have discussed in our special cases, right? So it will pass through center of curvature and it will retrace its path back. So the point of intersection between these two rays will be having the image, right? So we know that this is the top part, so its image will be formed here, and this bottom part, as it is already on principal axis, so the bottom part will be on the principal axis itself. So in this case the object is getting inverted, but it is right. Now this is the special one, because if an object is placed between focus and the pole, then it will have a, you know, virtual image, but it will be erect. So now this is on the basis of our all position of object, position of image and nature of size of object. So we have to just look at this and and these are the questions which we have to discuss, right? Thank you. I hope you like it. Thank you.